Hi, my name is Andrei Osterchuk. This is Google Sheets Data Connector for Adobe Analytics. And in this video, you will learn how to upload classifications directly to Adobe Analytics. And first, let's briefly talk about the workflow. The classifications workflow consists of several steps. First, you need to create a template, then fill in the template with the data, with the classification itself. And finally, you need to upload this classification to Adobe Analytics. Let's start from a template. Click Create a Template, and a new tab will be added to your spreadsheet. This is how it looks. And a few words about the classification. So there are a few ways how classifications can be uploaded to Adobe Analytics. The first way is fully automated. This is when your backend platform is integrated with Adobe Analytics, and in this case, you don't need to care about how this works. You just know that every day you work with the data, the classifications are up to date. The second scenario is when you need to maintain and upload the classifications manually. And this is exactly when this add-on may be helpful for you. Usually when you maintain the classifications manually, this means that you have likely Microsoft Excel spreadsheet and you prepare classifications there, and then you export those classifications into TXT files. Then in most of the cases, you verify those TXT files to be compatible with the data format before you upload the data to the Adobe Analytics infrastructure. Then you use an FTP software to upload the file. And obviously this consumes quite much time. And if you maintain the classification for numerous dimensions, especially if you maintain more than one report suites, in total, this consumes significant time. With Data Connector for Adobe Analytics, you can simplify the maintenance of the classifications because now you can maintain the classifications in Google Sheets and upload the changes in a matter of single click. So let me tell you what you need to do in order to set up a classification and get prepared for manual upload. So first you need to run admin console, find the report suite or report suites that you want to run a classification for, find a dimension or dimensions, set up for them the classifications. Then you need to set up an FTP account linked to those classifications, get credentials for the FTP accounts, and afterwards you can export the templates for those classifications, because you really need to understand how the templates should look like. And afterwards you can proceed. Now I want to show you how to do this with Data Connector. So first, if you're an advanced user and you fully understand how the classifications work, you can start filling in this template right away. If you are not sure how the template works, I suggest you to do is to go to the templates, export the template, open it in the text editor, and copy the template in the cell A1 so that these lines will be replaced with your real template. So first, you may recognize some differences in this area, and obviously the difference will be here because these cells stand for the classification headers. In my case, I don't need to download the template because I will fill it in right here. So let's have a look first at our clickstream. We are going to create a classification for tracking code. And here we have two values, AdWords and email, as campaign IDs or tracking codes. And in this video, I want to create a classification exactly for these values. This is why I add these values in the keys. And in my classification that I set up on the backend, I have two dimensions. The first one is campaign channel, and the second one is called campaign name. So these are the classification. values, and now what I need to do is just to fill in this kind of template. So campaign channel, this is paid search. For the email, it will be email marketing. As for the campaign name, the first one will stand for paid search general, and the last one will be email marketing general. I hope you already know how the classifications work, but here I just demonstrate you a very simplistic scenario with just a few items, and hope this makes the story clear. So in order to run this classification upload, we need to know the FTP account. If you don't know your FTP account, again, you need to go to the admin console, find the classification, and check if you have the FTP account linked to it. If you don't have it, you need to create it. By the way, if you are not so familiar with classifications, maybe you want to enroll in one of my video courses on Adobe Analytics or sign up for a personal training. All right, so here, what we will need to set up first is the FTP account. So retrieve your credentials and then click on the FTP accounts. You will see that a new tab will appear, and on this FTP tab, there will be all accounts associated with your Google account. And here we have four fields: FTP account name, host username, and password. Host username and password is something that you will retrieve from Adobe Analytics, and account name is something that you will work with in this add-on. Basically, when you start loading the data, you need to select the account name to understand where the data will be loaded to. So how to work with it? Enter the account name. So you can enter any value that will be convenient for you. My advice is to use a naming convention where you have a prefix that is referring to classification, because in one of the other videos, we will also work with FTP accounts when we load data sources. Sometimes maybe you also want to add a suffix or a prefix for report suite. If you have more than one report suite you work with within one spreadsheet. So here it will be, in my case, classification tracking code. Then I will need to fill in the host, username, and password. Once you have entered the name, host, username, password, you need to click on the Save FTP. Only in this case, the data will be saved. You can see that the passwords are not shown, and this is made on purpose, just for security reasons. But if you want to update classification, the account name, you can do this. If you want to update the host, you can do this. But afterwards, click Save. Don't pay attention that the password will not be shown here. It's still saved accurately. So asterisks are never replace the real password here. So if you want to delete something from this sheet, you can delete the whole row and then again save FTP. Only in this case, the changes will be saved. So I will enter again the new FTP account and click Save to save it, right? So now the FTP account is saved, and that I will be using for classification upload. I always suggest you afterwards click on the Hide FTP sheet so that it will not be visible, and I prefer to do this every time. Okay, so now the FTP account is ready, and the final step is to load the classification to Adobe Analytics. Now, for this purpose, I hope you already guessed that we need to click on the Load link, and this will show you such a menu. First, select the datasheet that you need to load the data from. In my case, this is classification tab or sheet. And then here is the menu where you need to select one of the FTP accounts that you have. In my case, this is already pre-selected. And then if this is what you want to go ahead with, just click Load Now. And see what happens. So, first, the line status was added, and you can see that here is the date and time. This is when this was processed or uploaded, or when the attempt happened. And you can see the status. As usual, there will be always the status. And you can see that in my case, I entered a wrong either username or password or both. And this helps me to understand where the problem is. I made it on purpose so that you can see what statuses exist. So failure means that the data wasn't sent to Adobe and something happened. So here you can see a full explanation of what happened. So now what we need to do is to upload, is to update the FTP account. I will do this right away. Go to FTP accounts. And here I will need to update the credentials. I will do this and then we'll switch back to classification. I have updated the FTP account credentials. And again, let's see what will happen if we load the data again. Just click on the Load Now button. You see now that the status and the date have been updated. So what you need to know is, regardless of the status that was before, the data will be loaded anyway. So every time when you click on the Load Now button, your classification will be loaded to Adobe Analytics. And here is the loaded status telling you that everything was successfully uploaded. And then you can also see the file name that was uploaded to the FTP. So this is just for your information, but if you have the loaded status, everything was smoothly uploaded and everything worked as expected. So this is how you can work with the classifications maintenance. You can do everything in this sheet, and then in a matter of one click, everything will be automatically uploaded to Adobe Analytics. This is it for this video. Thank you for watching.